What I like most about being a realtor is the ability to help people build long-term wealth, follow their dreams, and find locations and homes to help them build memories for a lifetime. So when I talk about my favorite memories in serving a home buyer, whether it be helping my brother-in-law find a home for his brand new family, or helping the police captain from New York City move down here and retire right near Disney, which they're huge Disney fans, and the ability to be able to see the fireworks from their home. But I think my favorite memory was helping a family where both the grandparents chipped in to buy a property for their kids and their grandkids that had special needs that were diehard Disney fans. And to see the look on these kids' faces when they realized that they now owned a home, or their parents owned a home, that was so close to Disney and they can go whenever they want, was just, it just tugged at my heart. One tip I would give a buyer that's looking at moving to Central Florida would be to, let's understand what it is that you like to do, what experiences you like to have, and find a location that's going to meet those needs and those experiences. Whether you be a Disney fan and want to be near the theme parks, or whether you be somebody that loves the outdoors, where being near some of our state or national parks would benefit you. Orlando has so much to offer by really honing in on what your likes are and what you like to do with your free time would best help me be able to navigate how to help you best. My favorite thing about living in Orlando is the diversity of things to do. Literally, you could spend the day, a Saturday, at one of the many theme parks, whether it be Disney or Universal or SeaWorld or even Legoland. You can go that afternoon or early evening to see an amazing concert at the Amway Arena, and I've seen everybody from Pink to Andre Bocelli to Elton John there, or a Magic game, or even a Solar Bears game. And then the next day you can get up and head off to either coast to one of the many beautiful beaches, or make your way over to Kissimmee to the Silver Spurs Arena and watch a rodeo. So the diversity of things to do is so dynamic. It's what I love best about Orlando. So one of the fun facts you may not know about me is that in my younger years, I had the opportunity in a bunch of different roles of working with a number of musical bands across the United States. I got to work on the Family Values Tour and work with Staind and Linkin Park and Stone Temple Pilots. I got to work with Bare Naked Ladies. I got to work with George Strait Country Music Festival, the Cranberries. It was an interesting time in my life. And in many of those cases, I lived on a tour bus traveling the United States, working with the local radio stations and bringing in the hospitality. But it was a cool time in my life. So I grew up in a little town called Duxbury, Massachusetts. It was founded by John Alden and Miles Standish in 1622. It's right next to Plymouth, Massachusetts. It was a wonderful place to grow up. I couldn't have asked for a better place from my parents. I lived on the beach. School was right around the corner of it. And every afternoon after school, that's where we headed. And during the summer, after work or before work, that's where we headed. It was a great place to live. My very first job was pumping gas at the age of 13 years old at a local convenience store. And I got paid $1.25 an hour, I want to say under the table, but not for public record. Because I grew up in the land of the pilgrims, my favorite meal is Thanksgiving turkey dinner with cranberry stuffing and cranberry sauce and gravy and corn in the cob. But my favorite meal down here, my favorite restaurants, would be more of like Fleming Steakhouse, which is right nearby, is fantastic. Rocco's Tacos, which is a great taco place on the lake on Sand Lake Road, that is fantastic if you're just looking for something a little more casual with a laid-back atmosphere. But my favorite meal overall is turkey dinner for Thanksgiving. So, favorite movies. My favorite movie of all times is a movie called We Were Soldiers. It's a movie about the first time that American forces met North Vietnamese regulars. And it's not so much about the incident and the situation, but it's more about the leadership qualities that Colonel Hal Moore, who was the commanding officer that that ran into that situation and spent 3 days in the most horrific of environments. It's the way he led his men and the leadership that he showed to help everybody get through it. And then the way he recounted it later in life and actually met the commander of the opposing force and broke bread. It's a true story, and it's just a very emotional, powerful one to me. So the question was posed to me what my favorite band was, and that's a really hard one because I like everybody from, as I shared earlier, Andre Bocelli to Linkin Park or Stone Temple Pilots or Rage Against the Machine. So it's a really hard one for me to coin, but lately I've really been into James Blunt, which is totally different than the rest of them. So I would say right now, probably James Blunt. Nice, relaxing, easygoing music.